من شيء. That indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not reveal on the people nothing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refuted them. فَرَدَّ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيْهِمْ بِقَوْلِهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refuting them, meaning the mushriks. He said, قُلْ مَنْ أَنْزَلَ الْكِتَابِ الَّذِي جَاءَ بِهِ مُوسَى نُورًا وَهُدًى لِلنَّاسِ And this was the hal of the Yahud that used to deny the Quran. And likewise, that which led them to this was that the envy that they had, as the Shaykh Hafidhahu Allah Ta'ala, because they have some envy towards the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So having this envy towards the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam caused them to not only disbelieve the Quran, but disbelieve in likewise the book that was sent to Musa, and the books that were sent to all of the prophets alayhim salatu wasalam. And so therefore, barakallahu fikum, this feeling of envy, if it is in the heart of a person, then there is no good that will come out from him. Tayyib. So Allah Jalla wa'ala, he refuted them by saying, asking the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say, قُلْ سَيْ O Muhammad, مَنْ أَنْزَلَ الْكِتَابِ And who was the one that sent the book? الَّذِي جَاءَ بِهِ مُوسَى The book that Musa alayhi salatu wa salam came with. Nuran, that was light. وَهُدًا and guidance لِلنَّاسِ for the people. So this, barakallahu fikum, it was a clear refutation because the Yahud, they say, مَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَى بَشَرٍ مِنْ شَيْءٍ That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never revealed nothing on nobody. So this statement, barakallahu fikum, was in regard to Inkaru risalat kulliha. It was to deny all the message, barakallahu fikum, that was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Shafa, that in conclusion with this point in the aspect number 50, he say, Fandhuru. He say, look, ma yuf'alu al-hasid bi ahlihi. He say, look what envy can do to its people. He say, likewise, the people of Jahmiyyah, he say that they say that Al-Quran lam yanzil min indillah. Likewise, the Jahmiyyah, they say the same statement as the Yahud. They say that the Quran was not revealed. طيب. And likewise, they will say, وَقَوْلُ مَنْ قَائِلُ And the statement of those who say, إِنَّ السُنَّةَ لَيْسَتْ وَحْيًا مِّنَ اللَّهِ And likewise, those who say that the Sunnah, it is not a revelation from Allah. But they say that إِنَّمَا هِيَ مِنْ إِجْتِهَادِ الرَّسُولِ وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ But they ascribe the Sunnah to be from the efforts of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in finding the truth, which is completely a lie. So indeed, the Jahmiyyah, they lied. As the Yahud, they lied. And as the Quraniyun, they lied. The Yahud, they lied because indeed Allah is the one that sent down, revealed the book on Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as he had revealed that book unto Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And the Jahmiyyah, they lied because indeed the Quran, the harf of it, the huruf of it, and the meaning of it, it is all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is indeed wahyun min Allah. It is indeed a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, so therefore, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, the new print tonight will be al-mas'ala al-hadiyatu wa khamsoon, the aspect number 51. And the aspect 51, barakallahu fikum, it is that the people of Jahiliyyah, وصفهم للقرآن بأنه من كلام البشر that they mention or they describe the Quran to be from the statement of the human being. They say that the Quran is from the كلام البشر. It is from the statement of the human being. It is the speech of the human being. قولهم في القرآن as the people of Jahiliyyah used to say. And this was pertaining, barakallahu fikum, to the mushriks of the Arab. The mushriks of the Arab. As, barakallahu fikum, the aspect that we just passed by, juhudihim inzal al-kutub ala al-rusul, the denying the revelations of the book to the prophets, this was in regard to the Yahud, la'anahumullah. And here, barakallahu fikum, this aspect number 51, it is in regard to, barakallahu fikum, the mushriks of the Arabs, because they used to say that the Quran is min kalam al-bashar, that the Quran is from the speech of the human being. Shaykh Fawzan Hafidhahullah, may Allah give him good in this life and the hereafter, and as-sami'een, and from those who are listening, and those who, alhamdulillah, sitting in the jalsa, he mentioned min masail al-jahiliyyah, from the aspect of the people of jahiliyyah, annahum yaqulun, that they used to say, The people of Jahiliyyah used to say, "Inna al-Qur'an qawlul bashar." The people of Jahiliyyah, they used to say that the Quran is the speech of the human being. It is the speech of the insan, of the person, of the people. He say, "Kama qalahu al-Walid ibn Mughira." As Walid ibn Mughira, he used to say before he accepted Islam. And Walid ibn Mughira, barakallahu fikum, he was from the chief of the Banu Mahzum. He was from the chief of the Banu Mahzum. And he used to be in charge of the issues of the warfare. And he was a very successful businessman also. And he was the father of Ahsanta Khalid ibn Walid. He was the father of Khalid ibn Walid radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. So he say, as Walid ibn Mughira, he used to say, Tayyib, mean ascribing the Quran to be min kalam al-bashar.
Oh, jazakallah.
من كلام البشر, meaning to be the speech of the human being. He say, well, Sheikh Fawzan حفظه الله, went to say, he say, well, Quran كلام الله سبحانه وتعالى. Indeed, the Quran, it is the speech of Allah. It is the speech of Allah. Meaning, by what we read, by what we hear, and by what we recite, by what we say, recite, by what we read, and by what we look at in the Mus'haf, all of those is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is not created. It is not created. He say, indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takallama Allah bihi haqiqatan wa awhahu ila nabiyhi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam biwasitati Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam. He say, indeed, Allah has spoken. He has spoken in reality. And he has indeed, yani, inspired or gave it to the Prophet sallallahu, revealed it unto the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by way of Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. By way of Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. He say, فَهُوَ كَلَامُهُ حَقِيقَةٌ. He say, indeed, the Quran is truly, in actuality, the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At his last part of his life. Fima qara'na. So he mentioned that indeed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke, and from the truth, from the speech which is the Quran, his speech which is the Quran. And he said, and he revealed unto Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by way of Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam. Biwasitati Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam. And he said, wasammahu kalamuhu fi ayatin kathira. And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned the Quran as being his speech. He has defined the Quran as being his speech in many places in the Quran. And he say, for instance, the example of those verses is could be found in Surah Tawbah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned, وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِّنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ إِسْتَجَارَأَكَ فَأَجِرُهُ حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ, until they will hear the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He say, ثُمَّ أَبْلِغُهُ مَأْمَنَةً, and then you will escort them until in a place where they will have what? They will find some security or some safety. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned, if one of the mushrikeen, they want to seek that which is protection from you. وَإِنْ إِسْتَجَارَكَ أَحَدٌ وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِّنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ إِسْتَجَارَكَ, if one of the polytheists, they want to come and seek protection from you, he say, فَأَجِرْهُ, give him protection. حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ, until they will hear the speech of Allah. شوف, حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ, until they will hear the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah himself, he mentioned the Quran is his speech. حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ, until they will hear the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this was in Surah Tawbah, verse number 6. Likewise in Surah Al-Fath, and Shaykh Fawzan hafidhahullah, may Allah give him good in this life and the hereafter, he's given us example in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the Quran as being his speech, his true speech, and he spoke with the Quran. So he mentioned here, as Allah Jalla mentioned in Surah Al-Fath, verse number 15, يُرِيدُونَ أَن يُبَدِّلُوا كَلَامَ اللَّهِ, that they wish to change the speech of Allah. They wish to change the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is Surah Al-Fath, verse number 15. Shaykh Fawdan hafidhahullah, he say, وَهَذَا هُوَ اِعْتِقَادُ أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ وَالْجَمَاعَةِ وَأَتْبَاعِ الرَّسُولِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And he say that this is the belief system. This is the creed of Ahlu Sunnati wal Jama'ah, that the Quran is the speech of Allah. It is not created. He say that this is the creed, this is the belief system of Ahlu Sunnati wal Jama'ah, and likewise those who follow, the meaning those who follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Shafawdan hafidhahullah, he went to say, he say, wal mushrikuna ya'rifuna annahu kalam Allah. That the mushrik, they knew indeed that it was the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They knew indeed it was the speech of Allah. He said, وَأَنَّهُ لَيْسَ مِنْ كَلَامِ مُحَمَّدٍ. And they knew that this was not the speech of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They knew that this was the speech of Allah. And they knew that this was the speech, this was not the speech of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لِأَنَّهُ لَوْ كَانَ مِنْ كَلَامِ مُحَمَّدٍ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam لَكَانَ بِإِسْتِطَاعَتِهِمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا مِثْلَهُ. He said, because if it was the speech of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then no doubt the mushriks, they had the ability to say this, the like of it. If it was the speech of Muhammad, then without a doubt they would have the means or the ability to produce the like of that. Because one of the things that the Arabs was very, yani, were very gifted in it, was they were very eloquent. They were having this fasaha. They were given the gift of the gab. They were very, yani, well spoken. طيب. So if this Quran was the speech of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he say, لَكَانَ بِإِسْتِطَاعَتِهِمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا مِثْلَهُ. If this was the speech of Muhammad, they will have the ability to reproduce the same speech. He say, لِأَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ بَشَرًا مِثْلَهُمْ مِثْلَهُمْ. Because Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a human being just like them. He's a human being like them. So if this speech was from him, then they would have had the ability to produce the same thing. Because Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Shaykh Hafidhahullah say, he say, because Muhammad, he is a bashar. He was a, he's a human being like them. He say, فَلَوْ كَانُوا أَوْ فَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ كَلَامِهِ. He say, if this was the speech of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَانَ بِإِسْتِطَاعَتِهِمْ أَنْ يُحَاكُوهُ. And if this was indeed the speech of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then they will have the ability to reproduce the same, to bring about the same thing, to reproduce the same, yani, wording and the like. But here he mentioned, وَاللَّهُ جَلَّ وَعَلَىٰ تَحَادُّوهُمْ. That indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has challenged them. أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has challenged them to bring the like of this Qur'an. To bring the like of this Qur'an. أو not even the whole Qur'an. أو بِعَشَرِ سُوَرْ مِثْلِهِ. Or to bring about 10 verses. 10 verses, yani, from the chapters. 10 chapters. 10 suwar, chapters. The like of it. أو بسورة واحدة مثله. Or to even bring one single surah. If this was the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah indeed subhanahu wa ta'ala has challenged them. He has challenged them to bring about the like of it. Or not even the whole Quran, but the like of 10 chapters. Not the whole 10, not a whole 10 chapter, but let them bring about one chapter, only one chapter. He say, فَلَمْ يَأْتُوا بِشَيْءٍ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. And they were not able to produce nothing like this. They were not able to produce or to reproduce the like of it. He say, مَعَ كُفْرِهِمْ وَعِنَادِهِمْ. And likewise, with despite their disbelief and their inad, their rejection of the truth, and likewise وَحَرْصِهِمْ أَوْ وَحِرْصِهِمْ عَلَىٰ مَشَاقَةِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. And likewise their eagerness to be in opposition with Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They have this eagerness to oppose Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, despite their disbelief and their rejection, and the eagerness that they have, the حِرْصِهِمْ عَلَىٰ مَشَاقَةِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ, and having this يعني this eagerness in opposing the messenger, in opposing Allah and the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. فلو كان باستطاعتهم